Let's discuss exponential functions. So to motivate our discussion, let's consider a population of bacteria that doubles every hour. And over here I have a little petri dish, and inside it I have 10 little bacteria. And when time is zero, that is when we're starting off, we start off with 10 little bacterium. Okay, let's keep a little table indicating what happens to the population as the time changes. So this will be time. And then right next to it, we'll have the population. So this will be the population at a given time. Okay, so when the population is zero, we know when the time is zero, the population is 10, right? That's because we're starting off with 10 bacteria. And when the time is up to 1 hour, well, the population is then gonna be 20, right? Because it doubled in that hour. Now 20 can be written as 10 multiplied by 2. And you'll see why we're doing that in a moment. Okay, after 2 hours, right, after one more hour, now the population doubles again. So now it's up to 40. Now 40, of course, to get to 40, all you have to do is multiply the 20 that you had by another 2. So this is going to be written as 10 times, well, you could write it as 4, but how about 2 squared, right? Simply multiplying this by another 2. And after 3 hours, well, now the population doubles again. So we're up to 80. And 80, of course, we can write that by simply taking what we had before and multiplying by yet another 2. So it'll be 10 times 2 raised to the third. So 3 twos. And let's do one more. At 4 hours, the population's up to 160. And then, of course, this is going to be 10 multiplied by 2 to the fourth, right? So you can see what's happening here. In every situation, the time becomes the exponent. So the time at 4 hours, the exponent is a 4. 3 hours, the exponent is a 3. Now, it's also true here, when the time is 1, you know, you can think of 2 as 2 to the first. And even when the time is 0, yeah, 10 is 10, but you can write that as 10 times 1, and then 1 can be thought of as 2 to the 0. So it's like having 10 times 2 to the 0. So in each case, you have the time giving you the exponent. So if somebody asked you, well, you know, for a given time t, what would the population be? You'd say, well, it's going to be, you know, predicting based on what we talked about a moment ago, or seeing these results, it's going to be 10 multiplied by 2. And then what happens with the time? It becomes the exponent. Okay, so this is a new type of function for us. And the new type of function is where the variable occurs in the exponent. So let me write that right here, 2 to the t. And I know there's a 10 here, but let's focus on the 2 to the t. This is called an exponential function. Exponential function. And an exponential function, you can always recognize them when the variable is in the exponent. Okay, so let's write that down, that the variable is in the exponent. That's how you know you've got an exponential function on your hands. Now compare that with what we've seen before, something like t squared. That would not be an exponential function because the variable is the base, not the exponent. In fact, we've seen this before. This is the quadratic function. Generally, we call these power functions. So we've talked about power functions in the past. Now we're talking about exponential functions, and they are ones with that have variables in the exponent, or a variable in the exponent. Okay, now that we know what they are, let's go ahead and see what their graphs look like. Okay, so let's go ahead and graph f at x equals 2 to the x. Now, whenever you meet a new function, it's always nice to create a table of values. So I'm going to pick values of x and figure out what the corresponding y's are. So let's go ahead and do that here. So for x's, you know, these are values that I'm choosing to plug in. Let's go with, how about 0, 1, 2, 3, and how about negative 1, negative 2, and negative 3. I'm just picking these arbitrarily so that we can get an idea of what this function looks like. Okay, so when x is 0, right? So what happens? Well, f at 0 is 2 to the 0, and 2 to the 0 is equal to 1. Now, if you write it out, it looks like this, right? f at 0 equals 2 to the 0, and anything to the 0 is 1. So when you plug in 0, out comes 1. Now when you plug in 1, 2 to the first is just 2. When you plug in 2, 2 squared is going to be 4, of course. When you plug in 3, 2 to the third, it's not 6. 2 to the third is equal to 8, because it's 2 multiplied by itself 3 times. Now when you plug in negative 1, something interesting happens. Let's write that down here. F at negative 1, well, that's 2 to the negative first. And that can always be written as 1 over 2 to the positive first. Do you remember that? You can write an exponential expression in the denominator, and the exponent changes sign. And 1 over 2 to the first is just equal to 1 half. So when you plug in negative 1, out comes 1 half. And likewise, you'll find that when you plug in negative 2, out comes a fourth, 1 over 4. And then likewise, when you plug in negative 3, out is going to come 1 eighth. Let's go ahead and show that one. So f at negative 3 is going to be 2 to the negative third, right? The x, you take the x and you write it as the exponent. So that's going to be 1 over 2 cubed. And 1 over 2 cubed is 1 eighth. Okay, so let's write that down. When you plug in negative 3, out comes 1 eighth. Okay, so I have a table of values here. So let's go ahead and plot all these points. When x is 0, I get 1. When I plug in 1, I get 2. When I plug in 2, I get 4. And when I plug in 3, I get 8. So way up here. Okay, how about when x is negative? When you plug in negative 1, you get 1 half, right there. When you plug in negative 2, you get a fourth, so way down here. And when you plug in negative 3, you get 1 eighth, so tiny. So what's happening is that the y values are getting smaller and smaller. They never quite reach the x-axis, right? Because it's going to be 1 over something. They never quite reach 0. Sorry, they never reach the x-axis. They never quite reach 0, but they get smaller and smaller. So if you get more and more points, you're going to find that you get a curve that looks like this. So let's go ahead and sketch that curve in now. And there it is. So this is called an increasing exponential function. And the reason we call it that, let's go ahead and write that down. Increasing exponential function. And the reason we call a function, or we call a function increasing, when you go from left to right on the graph and the function gets larger. Now you can see that the domain of this function is from negative infinity to infinity. You can plug in whatever real number you want, but the range, right? What y's potentially come out of the function? You never quite reach 0, so the range is from 0 to infinity. Okay, now increasing exponential functions aren't the only type of exponential functions. Let's go ahead and see another variety. Let's graph f at x equals 1 half to the x. So once again, it's an exponential function because I see the variable is at the exponent. So let's create a table of values once again. This is a favorite activity of ours. Okay, when x is 0, let's go 0, 1, 2, 3, negative 1, negative 2, and negative 3. Okay, when you plug in 0, you get 1, once again, because 1 half to the 0 is 1. When you plug in 1, 1 half to the first is a half. When you plug in 2, 1 half squared is a fourth. When you plug in 3, you're going to get 1 eighth. Now, when you plug in negative 1, once again, something interesting happens. So let's see that. F at negative 1 is going to be, well, 1 half to the negative first. Now, there's another way of dealing with the negative exponent in this situation. Do you see how the base is a fraction? You can make the exponent positive by taking the reciprocal of the base. So you can write this in the following way. 2 over 1 to the positive first. Those two things happen at the same time. You make the exponent positive and take the reciprocal of the base. And of course, this is simply equal to 2. It's 2 over 1, which is 2, raised to the first power. So when you plug in negative 1, out comes 2. And you'll find that when you plug in negative 2, out's going to come 4. And let's plug in negative 3 together. So f at negative 3 is going to be Let's see, 1/2 to the negative third. And once again, we're going to play that little game where you take the reciprocal of the base and change the exponent to make it positive. So it's going to be 2 over 1 to the third. And then 2 cubed, of course, is equal to 8. Okay, so these are ordered pairs here. Let's go ahead and plot them. So 0, 1, 1, 1/2. Okay, 2, 1/4. Oh, this is much different behavior, right? 3, 1/8. So getting smaller now as x increases. And now for the, when you plug in or when you plot these points, negative 1, 2. So we're way up here. Negative 2, 4. Oh, way up here now, right? And then negative 3, positive 8. Way up there. So you can see what's happening. The curve is going to look like this. Let's go ahead and graph that curve now. And you can see here that we have a decreasing exponential function. So this would be called a decreasing exponential function. Now, you can see once again, of course, that the domain is the same as before, right? Negative infinity to infinity, and same with the range. You're still never quite reaching zero. It's getting smaller and smaller, but the range is still zero to infinity. Okay, now we've seen two types of exponential functions. Let's go ahead and just summarize what to expect and why. So first of all, an exponential function looks like f at x equals a, where a is called the base, raised to the x. Now if a is between 0 and 1, then you have a decreasing exponential function. And if a is larger than 1, then that would be increasing. So an example for the first would be something like this. If f of x was equal to 1/3 to the x, right? The base here, a, is between 0 and 1, and that's decreasing. And that kind of makes sense, right? Because you're constantly multiplying by a third. So a third times a third times a third. And every time you multiply by a number less than 1, if the number is positive, you end up making the quantity smaller, so it's decreasing. Likewise, if you have something like this, g of x is equal to 3 to the x, what are you doing? You're constantly multiplying by 3. Well, 3 is larger than 1, so you're making the quantity larger. Okay? So that's what exponential functions are, and that's how we graph them. Until next time.